During week 8 of the OPL, I don't think a lot went right for us.
The loss versus Auto was pretty, it was bad. Like, I felt bad about it because that game was in our hands despite the bad early game.
I think the game was close up until the Baron call, as you said. I think we got very flustered and we panicked and we thought, oh fuck, if we can't get the Baron here, we probably won't get the Baron in this game. And we started rushing it.
There's a lot of things that went wrong. We didn't execute on our plan. We got punished a lot early on. However, I think the silver lining is we still have more time and we can work on these issues.
Because if you can start controlling this side, like this, then that's gonna be really easy to roam and do stuff like this. Like whichever way you wanna do it. So the first step.
If you can control the pink next to the red, then the pixel pinks are relevant.
That's wonderful. That's not danger.
Good luck, boys.
Don't say good luck back.
That's on camera, I get it. I want that in the next episode.
There's much worse on camera.
Shut up.
Hi, how are you?
Howdy.
D5
does
definitely
not
D5.
What?
It's 1-4.
Oh, okay. They got rid of D5?
Yeah,
I haven't got rid of D5.
I genuinely can't leave it.
Bro, I haven't been in Diamond in 10 years.
What on the rank reset?
Oh, people still make D5 jokes.
Do you want to trade a D4?
No, I skip. I'll skip Diamond. I go Platinum 1 to Challenger.
Oh, that makes sense.
I'm
leading for a second.
One more.
I sneak Winston in this time.
Wait a minute.
Alright, good luck out there, boys. Have fun. If Jesse Fees is getting dropped. Legacy on three.
Legacy on three!
If I sound lazy, just ignore my tone. Cause I'm always gonna answer when you call my phone. Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger?
Mark's washing his hands. That's a very good for us. That's a very good sign.
That's very good.
That means he wants to win.
Why are you washing your hands?
I already did.
Fair enough.
Kind of.
Alright, so we got the camera dude and the dude camera dude and the camera dude. Double camera dude.
Dude camera reception.
What a bunch of dudes.
Dude camera. He did message me. Cock dude.
Oh, yeah.
The problem is when you break a cockroach's neck, they don't actually die. So you're gonna have to do a little bit more than that, buddy. Yeah, no, they can run around with no head.
Can we show Dobes real quick?
Is anyone showing you there?
They better be.
If we first exile, you can't play it.
No.
Or not.
Definitely.
Maybe.
Howdy, Winston. I'm just here stretching and then I got cameras on me and like, oh. Alright, fair enough.
Maybe we can still defend.
Keep him alive for a whole lot longer and
Alright, I'm going to go on Zoe.
Yeah, I'm going to go on now.
They have no Kindred ult.
Lucky boys.
I'm not sure why the team was nervous when we had numbers advantages, especially in the order game. My only thought would be it's just stage nerves that haven't really gone away yet. I think this is something that, again, with time, things can be solved. It's definitely not something that exists in practice.
I try and keep it as close as I possibly can. I try and make sure that I don't differentiate at all, but I do think I still do. I think I have a bit of stage fright myself. I think I definitely play a lot more passive than I would like to be. I think we just get scared on stage. I think we still have, I think we've developed stage fright. I don't think we had it earlier on, up until about, I'd say week four, week five-ish. And then since then, I feel like we've had a stage fright. I'm not entirely sure why, but I think that's the symptom.
I'd say, our scrims aren't really translating to on stage in terms of like how we think about the game and how we communicate. It's just, it's not the same right now, and we just got to work on it and try to translate that.
I'm not looking to make any changes for how many games we play. As for what we're specifically practicing, well, that's always based around sort of finishing everyone off as players, like making them a bit more well-rounded before we work in just purely winning games for Split 2. As Split 1 ends, we don't have a lot to be specifically playing for in terms of promotion or Gauntlet or anything like that. So what our main focus is just being on improvement, as it has been the entire Split, and trying to get everyone to kind of get rid of that stage nerves if they still have any.